Hey, I'm Vitanis. In this guide, I'll show you how to utilize the custom parsing instructions feature in the Scraper API's playground. It's the go-to option when you want to get structured data, but our pre-built parsers don't cover your target websites. There are three ways you can parse HTML content with custom parsing instructions in the playground. This video will focus on the third method, creating instructions from scratch, but let's quickly see the first two methods in action. The easiest option is to use existing templates with predefined parsing instructions. First, let's pick a source for a target website. Let's say you want to scrape this eBay product page. So in the Playground menu, you want to select the Other Domains option under E-commerce Scraper API when there's no dedicated parser for your target e-commerce website. Next, enter your target URL into the URL field like this. You may also want to tweak the available parameters in case you don't receive the expected results. Let's leave these settings as is and jump straight to the output type section. This is where you can use custom parsing instructions. Once you toggle the parse parameter, a new button will appear. Click it and then select Use Our Templates. Once you do that, another window will pop up, allowing you to select an existing template from a list. In case you have written your own parsing instructions code, you can simply copy and paste it into the playground. For this, select the second parsing instructions option called Import Your Code. I have these basic instructions for an eBay product page, so I'll copy the entire code. Now, in this new window, paste our code like this and click Save. Next, you can adjust any instructions if needed, and once again, click the Save button to save everything. Alternatively, you can also use the built-in interface to create your custom parsing instructions from scratch. First, let's get back to the window where you can choose the custom parsing instruction type. Now, select the third option, Start from Scratch. In this new window, you can see an interface for crafting instructions, and on the right side, the code itself. I'll show you how to build a basic parser that extracts the product title, the price, and the item condition. Start by adding an object to parse the product title. Notice how the code on the right refreshes with new information. Give this object a title name, and then add a pipeline. Right now, all we have is a key name and an empty function that doesn't parse any data yet. So from the drop-down menu, you want to select a function that gets the first value matching a CSS selector. I'll get back to the eBay product page and open my developer tools. Let me select the title element. And as you can see, the title is inside a span element that's wrapped with an H1. So in the playground, you can simply enter H1 into the argument field. If you run the current code, it will return the entire H1 element, as you can see. You can extract the element's text by adding another function to the pipeline and then selecting the extract text from HTML option. Now let's save everything and run the code again to see the difference. Here you can see just the title. Let's add more instructions to parse the product price and its condition. Start by adding another object and give it a price name. Next, add a pipeline and choose the CSS1 option. In the developer tools, you can see that the price text is inside a span element, as inside a div element which has a specific class set to xPricePrimary. We can target this exact class. So let's get back to the playground and enter the CSS selector for the price. Once again, add another function to the pipeline that retrieves the text from the entire element. After that, create another object, call it condition, and add a new pipeline. Let's do this part a little bit differently by using an XPath selector. make sure to select a function that gets the first value matching an XPath expression. With XPath, you can directly extract the text from an element, so you won't need to define an additional parsing instruction that parses the text. Using developer tools, you can find the product condition text inside a span element, which is also inside a div element with a specific class set to xItemConditionText. Using this information, you can form the XPath selector like this. And since XPath allows selecting text nodes, let's add the text function to select the text node. Copy the selector, head back to the playground, and paste it into the argument field. That's it. Save your parsing instructions, and let's run this code again to see the results. Here's the parsed price, the title, and the condition. In this tutorial, we've touched upon a few functions for parsing an eBay product page, but feel free to test out other functionalities for your projects. Head to our documentation where you can find everything you need for a smooth start. That's all, folks. Happy testing and see you next time.